Unfortunately, only have a couple of minutes. There will be another group coming in. I don't want to hold them up. So if a few people can ask your questions, and then our speakers will provide any thoughts. But please keep your questions to give the time to just one or two sentences.
I'm Dr. Judith Yates. I'm a family doctor from England, and we very much support your cause. We have, I'm part of International Doctors for Health-Based Drug Policies. We have 1,600 doctors from 104 countries, of whom 9 doctors in the Philippines are members. And we believe that drugs should be a health policy, not a conundrum policy. And in this CMD, we're launching this the International Standards for the Treatment of Drug Use Disorders, and it's shocking to hear what you're telling us from the Philippines. We'd like to offer your support if you can.
Thank you so much.
Yes.
I think the center and the human rights is giving us the fake or the, not the real figure of the Philippines. Because the 3,000 is only, accepted by the police, but the 16,000 is home site. So you could not equate the 3,000 to 16,000, and you could not sum it up into 20,000. That's very dubious. And the other one is, Mr. Senator, you are saying that the popularity of the president is going down. But if you look at the survey, there are already 85% of the Filipinos supporting the president. Why? Because they feel that they are safe now, compared to the previous administration. I am from Mindanao. Yes, there is martial law in Mindanao, but we don't feel the martial law of Marcos in Mindanao. We are free to roam around. And we feel that we are protected against the communists, against the ISIS, who is working in Mindanao. So I think the senator, and I believe the senator is not giving us the right figure. He is falsely leading us to believe that what he has is right. The Philippine government is also protecting the lives of the innocent people. Drug dealers and drug lords are not armless. No, they have guns. They are ready to kill our police or law enforcers. How many police we have died during the operation? They are using what we call the standard, legal engagement. How to deal with criminals. How to take care of the criminals. So our criminals and drug lords in the Philippines are really like criminals because they have arms. They are armed. They are fully armed. So I don't think you are picturing the Philippines, you are painting the Philippines in a bad scenario where the majority of the Filipinos is supporting the president. Human rights? How about the human rights of those who are innocent?
So we've been asked for the by the next group to allow them to prepare any questions.
Well, I was very careful in presenting the data. This data came from the Duterte administration.
Yet only the 3,000, but the 16,000 is in doubt.
The 16,000 is here.
It's there.
It is there. Yeah. Yeah, so, we're very careful. And it was reported in the media. They presented it publicly in the media. Now, I totally understand where you're coming from. You're not privy to the kind of information that we have. We're looking at things on the ground. I'm 100% sure that if you saw what we have seen, then your opinion will also change. Now, as to the public opinion polls, when Duterte assumed office, his rating was in the 90s. You know that. That's a fact. That's also reported. Now, last December, it's in the 80s, as you said.
Yep.
But wait until the next survey comes. That's what I said. It's relatively high. I consider that.
You are predicting the president
it's
to pull
not
down.
The dialogue. You asked the question. Okay.
No, but again, I totally understand the Filipinos who remain supportive of Duterte because they're not privy to the kind of information that we have. I totally respect that. Someday in the future, we will be on the same side. These Filipinos are good Filipinos as well. It's just a matter of access to information.
Quickly. Yeah, December 2016, actually, the Philippine National Police had been bragging about the figures. It was 5,000 plus. One. Second, his popularity is hyperinflated. There's a huge silent majority, actually. Essentially, there's that active consensus from the middle class, which is insulated from the killings. There are huge urban poor communities who voted for Duterte but have changed their minds. It's the train, actually, now that is turning things over. That a law that is actually has actually caused the spike of basic commodities in the Philippines.
Okay. So thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.